creating accessible Excel documents. Content developed by New Edition Consulting. Welcome. Thank you for joining this discussion on how to create accessible Excel documents. In this video, we'll cover how to set a document's properties, properly structure tables, effectively use color and contrast, assign unique worksheet names, and insert hyperlinks. First up is document properties. It is important that documents have a clear and concise title to help users know what document they are viewing. To set a descriptive document title, navigate to File, and then Info. Under the Properties section is the Title field, and this is where you'll enter a unique title for the specific document that you're working on. So for this document, I'll title it Class Demographics. Once you've entered your unique title, you can navigate back to the document. Now we'll discuss how to structure and design tables properly. First, make sure that you are using headings to style sections of the document. Headings indicate the beginning of a new section or major section, and headings should be selected based on their hierarchy or importance in the document. Excel offers four levels of headings, a heading level 1 through a heading level 4. To assign headings, highlight the cell that contains the desired title. So for this document, I'm going to enter my title in cell A1. I'll highlight that text and then navigate to the Home ribbon and the Styles pane to assign my title a heading level 1. In addition to assigning appropriate headings to your document, you also need to make sure that you are designing your table properly. There are several things to keep in mind as you structure your table. Keep tables simple and only have one table per worksheet. Complex tables are difficult for users of assistive technology to understand, so keeping your table simple will help all users access the information. A complex table might include a table that has merged cells. There's a Merge Cells button under the Alignment section of the Home tab. If this button is highlighted, then you'll know that you have some merged cells in your table. Make sure that that Merge Cells button is unselected to be sure that your table is simple. If you have a complex table, either split the table into multiple simple tables or provide instructions on accessing an alternative version. The second thing you want to remember is to never use spaces, the tab key, or visual borders to simulate the appearance of a table. Sometimes it might look like you have a properly structured table because there's a bordered outline. But this bordered outline doesn't necessarily mean that you have structured your table properly. The third thing you want to remember is to avoid having blank rows or columns. Be sure to include information in every cell of the table. The last thing you want to remember is to avoid blank cells, especially in the header cells. Always make sure to mark data tables using the Insert Table function to identify which table cells should be included in the table and identify table headers. So I'm going to begin to build my table. My first table header will be name, then state, and age. Then I'll begin to enter some of the table data. As I continue to enter the data, I want to remember that I need to make sure that my table is structured properly using the Insert Table function. So now that I have some information, I'm going to select the table, navigate to the Insert tab, and select the Table function. Once the Create Table window populates, I want to make sure that the My Table Has Headers button is selected. Now I have properly structured my table using the Insert Table button. And now I know that users of assistive technology will be able to access the information in the table, and the data cells, like the name or the state, will be associated appropriately with the header cells, which are the name, state, and age. Along with using proper table structure, be sure to use color and contrast effectively. Color ensures that content is readable, accessible, and appealing. Using color effectively means not using color as the only means to convey information, but also verifying that the text color provides enough color contrast against the background. You want to make sure that there is a minimum color contrast of 4.5 to 1. There are a number of tools online that you can access to determine the ratio of the colors. I have a color contrast analyzer I save on my toolbar because I use this tool often. And I can select the background color as well as the foreground color. And this tool will automatically generate the ratio. So I can see that this color contrast is 4.7 to 1. So it exceeds the minimum 4.5 to 1. And the stronger that contrast, the better. To select a font color, you can navigate to the font color picture in the font section under the Home tab. And you can select a number of different colors for your text. Just make sure that as you select colors, you're ensuring that the ratio between the background and the foreground meets that minimum 4.5 to 1. Next up is worksheets. Worksheet names should provide information about what is found on that particular worksheet, making it easier to navigate throughout a workbook. Any blank sheets in a worksheet should be removed. To assign worksheet name, right-click the Sheet tab, click Rename, and then type a brief unique name that describes that particular sheet's content. So for this worksheet, I'm going to name it Demographics. If I had a second sheet with another table on it, I would name this worksheet specific to the content that's present on this particular worksheet. Now we'll discuss how to insert hyperlinks. When including hyperlinks in your Excel document, it is important to be as descriptive as possible. Link text needs to be meaningful and in a manner that describes the purpose of the link. So generic phrases that, such as more or click here, do not describe what the link relates to or where it leads, and they should be avoided. Instead, clear and unique link text should be used. So to add a hyperlink, you want to make sure that before the hyperlink, you're also including descriptive text that will cue the user into where that information will take them. So before I enter my hyperlink, I'm going to enter some text. So this text will give the user an idea of where the hyperlink will take them. Place the cursor where the hyperlink is to be added, on the Insert ribbon, in the Links group, activate Hyperlink. This will open the Insert Hyperlink dialog box. In the Text to Display field, briefly describe the link's destination. And in the Address field, insert that qualified URL. Navigate to and activate the OK button. After following these steps, you will have a descriptive hyperlink in your worksheet. One thing to remember that as you're adding hyperlinks in Excel, the hyperlink text will be present in a cell separate from the preceding text. And this allows users of assistive technology, particularly users who are using their keyboard to navigate the information, to access that URL and activate it separate from the information that it's associated with. So making sure that you enter this hyperlink into a cell outside of any surrounding text will allow users to access that information. Now that I have finished creating my Excel worksheet, I'm going to do a mental rundown of the items that I know need to be included to create an accessible Excel document. So first, I'm going to remember that I need to have proper document properties, and that's the title that I entered earlier. I'm also going to make sure that my table is structured properly. I used the insert table function and identified that my table did have header rows. I set a title and made sure that that title was set as a heading level 1. I used descriptive text when I was entering in a hyperlink. And then I also want to make sure that I used a unique worksheet name, which I did. Oh, but it also looks like I forgot to remove that extra worksheet. So before I finish up, I'm going to select that extra worksheet and delete it. And now I know that I have created an accessible Excel worksheet. This concludes our discussion on how to create accessible Excel documents. For more accessibility resources, visit the NCRTM Accessibility Resources page.
For additional help, feel free to contact the NCRTM support team and contact them at ncrtm@newadditions.net.